In this video, we're given a velocity time graph, and then we're asked to find the instantaneous acceleration at a particular moment in time. And in part B, we're asked to find the average velocity on a time interval. We're told the grid spaces can be trusted in this graph. And I'll just adjust my title real quick. That's velocity in meters per second on the y-axis. And then I have time in seconds on the x-axis. So you can trust the numbers you see in the graph. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 meters per second for the velocities, and then 1 through 6 seconds for the times. Now, to get the instantaneous acceleration at t equals 4, I go to that point on the graph. When t is 4, I'm right here, and v looks like it's about 2.5. Well, the acceleration at that moment in time is just the slope of the graph. And the easiest way to get the slope is to focus on integer points here, and I have a couple integer points that are connected by that line segment. Then I look at the rise between these two points as t goes from 3 to 5. And the rise is going to be a negative number. That's a negative 3 meters per second. And the run is a positive 2 seconds. I could be more formal about it and say that A is going to be delta V over delta T, the slope of the graph. And my final velocity here is 1 meter per second. My initial velocity was 4 meters per second. My final time, 5 seconds. My initial time is 3 seconds. And this gives me the same thing. I have a negative 3 meters per second divided by 2 seconds. And I can see this simplifies to negative 1.5 meters per second per second, or meters per second squared. In part B, I'm asked to compute the average velocity from t equals 0 to t equals 6. And average velocity is the change in position divided by the change in time. And I have to remember here that change in position is given by the area under the velocity time graph. So I've got to find the area under this thing. And I'm going to think of it as a rectangle, and then a trapezoid, the big trapezoid, and then a little trapezoid. And I have to remember that the area under a trapezoid is the average of the two heights on the left and right side multiplied by the width of the base. So delta x starts with the area of this rectangle, and that has a base of 3 seconds and a height of 4 meters per second. And then the area of the large trapezoid that has a base of 2 seconds, it has one height of 4 meters per second, and then another height of 1 meter per second. And I take the arithmetic mean of those two heights. So that's 1/2 times their sum, 1/2 of 4 meters per second plus 1 meter per second. And then times the width of the base, which was 2 seconds. And then finally, I have the small trapezoid, and I already have one of its heights written in the diagram, and the height on the right-hand side there is 2 meters per second. So I add in a 1/2, and then a 1 meter per second plus 2 meters per second times the width of the base there, which is just 1 second. You can see in all the units that seconds are gonna cancel, leaving me with meters, which is good because we're talking about displacement. And this gives me a grand total of 18.5 meters displacement. Then just a little reminder of what the total change in time is on this interval. T went from 0 to 6, so delta T is equal to 6 seconds. And I can finally write down my average velocity. Displacement was 18.5 meters. Time, 6 seconds. And I get 3.08 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.